So as I was saying you, let me show you some simple example. If it is looking complex to you, what we can see, we will try for some simple example. There are multiple examples are here. You can pick any one and you can see how they are making the graph, or you can just click on this tutorial. In this tutorial, you try for this graph. So now you can see here. It is having only 3 to 4 line of the code. Okay, so let me write down here. What will be the step of drawing the line graph? Okay, so for that, again, you have to just write down import matplotlib. See, when you type it, it will going to suggest you in the Colab. Just click matplotlib, then what is pyplot? You can see PLT, yeah. It will going to suggest you, right? Then what is there here? It will going to here. You have to decide like what will be your labels, okay? What will be your Y label? What is your plot, right? You wanted to draw, right? So here, so I wanted to draw between these two data. So I'm just taking this, okay? PLT plot and RO means for red color. If you want to make a dot with a red color, you have to give. So for that, what you're going to write? PLT dot subplot. You can see it is suggesting as well, right? So you can practice from your side as well. You can write subplot or you can write plot, both are correct. And then inside this square bracket, you can give a data 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. And here I'm taking 1, 3, 5, 7, 11, and I want red color, so I'm just giving RO. And for this RO, I have to take it in a single quote. You can see here, right? You can follow the document and you can practice as well from your side. I'm just explaining you from the given example so that this you can prefer this document. I can make a code without this as well, but to give you a document, I'm making the graph from this. Okay. Let me draw this graph, then I will going to explain you. Okay, let me run this. So you can see we have drawn the graph, but nothing is appearing here. So maybe we have not made the correct graph. So I need to check it here. Okay, the red arrow is not coming here. Okay, let me take it other data. Yeah, now you can see it's coming. The data was why we are not getting, because it was not able to predict that. Means it was not able to form a relation between the data. What actually it is, see. I have taken what 1, 3, 5, 7, 11. Okay, that will be my plot. Okay, that will be my data. Okay, and it will going to draw between 0, 6, 0, 20. So how it is? This 0, 6, 0, 20 will be the this data, and 1, 3, 5, because the not a bigger graph will come. So I'm just trying with a simple value. If you want, you can change this value as well. Let me take it simple value otherwise. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm taking 4 data. And here I'm taking 2, 4, 6, 8. Drawing the graph is very simple here. Okay, I missed something, I think. 1, 2, 3. Okay, here double comma. Okay, sorry. Square bracket here. Now I will rerun it. Now you see here, right? So one, when you see when it is one, the dot will be on the two. Okay. When it is two, the dot will be on the four, right? When it is three, the dot will be on the six. When it is four, the dot will be on the eight. Are you getting? Let me explain you once again. This arrow means what? Instead of line, you want dot, and that is of a red color. Okay. And this is making a graph between this data. Okay. How it is? See here, when it is one, what is the next data is two, right? You can just think when x value is one, y value will be two. When x value is two, y value will be how much? Four. So you can see it is coming near four. When x value is three here, or you can say when it is four, okay, what will be your value? Six, right? So it is coming nearby six. If you can take it straight, it will come here. And when it is three, when your value is three, it is six. It is something six. So it is, sorry, I think something I have made it. Okay, let me change here. Are you getting or looking some complex this? You are not
Yeah,
replying.
we are getting there. But like the top plot are the y-axis and x-axis, and the bottom number 06, 020, this is the
This is actually axis. It means that you can see 0 to 6 means this will be your 0 to 6 and 0 to
okay.
20. So this is 0 to 20.
Oh, okay.
You understand?
Yep.
Means your
Thank
this
you.
will be 0 to 6 and this will be 0 to 20. This is one thing. PLT dot plot, what it's doing, instead of line, I am making a circle dot. Let me try if any other symbol asterisk, let me try it. You can see asterisk is coming, right? Did you see that? So now when it is one, when your x value one, y value will be two. So you can see one, it is two. When x value is your, let me take instead of 20, let me take 10 and then see what changes. Now you see 0 to 10. Now it will come perfect. 1, 2, 2 to 4. You can see when it is 3, you have 6, right? So when it is 3, it will come 6. When it is 4, it is coming 4, right? So what do you understand from this? That when your x is increasing, your y is also increasing. You can just see that as you are increasing x, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. So your y is also increasing, right? So what decision you got it from this graph? कि अगर आप x वैल्यू को जैसे इंक्रीज करोगे, आपकी y वैल्यू भी इंक्रीज होगी, है ना? जैसा कि आप यहाँ पे देख रहे हो, x वैल्यू 1 है, तो y वैल्यू 2 है। फिर जब आपने x वैल्यू को इंक्रीज किया यहाँ पर, तो यहाँ पे y वैल्यू भी इंक्रीज हो गई, राइट? यहाँ पे फिर तुमने x की वैल्यू को इंक्रीज किया, तो यहाँ पे y की वैल्यू फिर आप लोग की इंक्रीज हो गई। अगेन आपने x की वैल्यू को 1 प्लस 1 किया, दैट इज 4 किया, तो यहाँ पे इंक्रीज हो गया। तो एक यहाँ पे लीनियर रिलेशनशिप आया। तो मतलब ये आप समझ सकते हो कि लाइक नाउ लाइक
Now.
या
The
फिगर
figure is
रिलेशनशिप
upwarding.
वेरिएबल
यस इट मीन दैट इट इज वर्टिकली इंक्रीजिंग राइट सो दिस काइंड ऑफ ग्राफ यू कैन मेक इट व्हाट डिसीजन यू आर मेकिंग फ्रॉम हियर दैट इफ यू इंक्रीज द एक्स वैल्यू योर वाई वाई वैल्यू विल आल्सो इंक्रीज
Increased.
या सो दिस काइंड ऑफ कॉल दिस इज वी कॉल एज डेटा एनालिसिस द वर्क ऑफ डेटा एनालिसिस व्हाट टू आइडेंटिफाई द पैटर्न To identify what we can understand from the data. Okay, for example, let me give you one more thing. Just write, let me write down this. Okay, What is the fuel price in US? In India, it is 110 rupees. So what is in US?
Around $3?
No, it's $4 per gallon.
$4, no.
Per liter, right?
Gallon.
Gallon. We measure in gallon.
Okay, you measure in gallon. So suppose, let me give you one scenario. Fuel quantity and price. Okay, there are two columns.
Amit, I have one question on this figure. If you go with that, that's fine.
Yeah, please ask me.
Okay, the question is in the programming language. You put over there, y axis, the figure is plt.axis 06010, right? That is the programming for y axis, right? And for the x axis, numerical value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, what is that programming on that, list? I get that.
Sorry, what you ask, I didn't understand. Can you just repeat?
So on the programming, the line, third line, plt.axis, you wrote over there the program 06010, right?
Yes.
That is the programming language for the y-axis, right?
Yeah. No.
And so what is the program?
This is not a program. This is for your graph, what will be the size of the graph, what value you want. Now here 0 to 6 I have taken, it means that my value in this range will be 0 to 6 and y-axis will be from 0 to 10. So this is about the graph. What will be the size of the graph and the value is in what range? Your main programming is this one, plt.plot, which first square bracket, 1, 2, 3, 4 will going to decide x-axis and 2, 4, 6, 8 will going to decide y-axis that you can see in the form of graph. You cannot see here, but you are seeing this red symbol that is telling you that when x value is 1, your y value will be 2. When x value is 2, y value will be 4. So this is the programming that you have written, this line. And this line is just telling you what ranges of value you want in this graph. When x axis is 0 to 6, you can instead of 6, you can take it. Close this. In place of 6, you can take it 5 as well. Why I should, and in place of this, I can take 9 as well. You can see here when I write 5 and in 9, so it is just telling the margin of the graph.
Okay. That means the axis and the plot dot axis, those axes are both for x axis and y axis, right?
Yes, correct.
Okay, got it. I think that was only for the y-axis. Okay, got it. Thank you.
Okay. So now suppose when your fuel quantity is 3 gallon, the price was something, suppose $3. But suddenly, as the precedent is changed, okay, so they decided to reduce the price. And now the price is reduced to $2.5. Then like for 5 liter, if you purchase, it will going to charge you 2.4, something like that. Okay, so what idea are you getting from here? As the fuel quantity is increasing, they are giving you a discount per gallon, right? When you purchase 1 gallon, it is cost you $1. When you purchase 2, it is $2, 3, $3. But suddenly, as precedent changes, they decide that if you purchase more quantity on the same day, same time, then you are eligible for discount and you will get at 2.5. So we have seen that, like if we purchase more fuel at the same time, we will going to save our money. That data, that analysis we have done here. We understand that. Instead of purchasing 1 gallon, if I purchase 5 gallon or 4 gallon, I will get a discount. So why should not I purchase this? So what analysis we have made here? Can you tell me what analysis or what understand that, what kind of understanding you get it here from this data?
We can purchase 5 gallon.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It is cheaper than other.
Yeah, good. Correct. You can purchase 5 gallon at the same time if you have a capacity on your vehicle, and or 4 gallon. If not, then 4 gallon. So that will be beneficial. So in the company when we work, the work of data scientists, data analysis, business analysis, their 3 designations are there: data analysis, business analyst, and data scientist. So company will provide you data. You have to understand this in term of programmatically with the help of Python code or with the help of your concept or your understanding. You have to find out and you have to represent in the form of graph and show it to your manager. So he, just by looking into the data, he can make a decision instead of looking the whole data, right? So this way we perform data science and data analysis. Now, some people, they say that they are not interested in a teaching. They might feel difficulty. They don't want to give put effort. So what they should do? For them, tools are available. Tableau, Power BI, Excel tool. These are the tools available where you don't have to have a programming knowledge, but you can, means it's not like that they are not interested in programming, so they can move to the tool. But I'm just telling in a general way, because if you are not interested in programming, then you can start learning tool as well. In the tool also, I will going to explain in the next week, like how with the help of tool, you can make a graph. I will going to show you how with the help of tool, you can make this graph in the Excel. In Excel also, we can make a tool. Okay, sorry. In Excel also, we can make such graph. So either you can learn programming or either you can learn tool. But the disadvantage of the tool is what? Tool is continuously changing. As the time change, tool is changing. Okay. Earlier, we were using Excel. Now we were using Tableau. We were using Power BI, right? So that is a, that there might be a chance that people will going lose job because they only know the outdated tools, and now new tools are available. But if you know the programming, it will never get outdated. If new programming come based on the idea of this programming, you can learn new program. So that's the reason why it's very important to have a knowledge of programming as well with the tool. So if suppose if new tool come and the tool that you have a knowledge is outdated, you can still survive in the companies and you can get a good job and good package. That's the reason the course is a combination of programming and tool. I hope you are already aware about it. Am I clear?
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So I'm not saying you like that. You can learn tool as well. I will definitely make you understand tool, but I will suggest you should don't forget the syntax of programming, because in interview, they will going to ask you programming as well as tool as well. And I assure you, if you learn programming and any one of the tools, either Tableau, Excel, Power BI, 99% you will get selected. You just have to remember the syntax and you should able to answer it confidently there. So I hope it is understand like what is data analysis and this. Now, how you can practice it? Now the question is, if you want to practice it, how you can practice? Okay, this is one more question. So what you can do? This is a Python tutorial, right? Now here, for drawing this graph, you can get the code here, okay? What you can do, just copy this code. You can click here, okay? Copy the code, paste it here, and start trying to make changes on that. Okay, let me run this. Okay, it has drawn the graph. You make changes like here. What changes you make in place of this? you try with some other name. A, in place of group B, you try with B. In place of group C, you try with C and run it. Now check the graph, what changes come. Now you see here, A, B, C is coming. Earlier it was group A, group B and group C, like you can see here. So what you understand that? You understand that if you make changes to this line, that is your name variable, you will going to change the x-axis. Now here value is 1, 10, 100. Let me make changes here. 1, 5, 50. And I'm rerun this. Now you see here, what changes are coming? This value reduced to 0 to 50 in the range, right? So by making changes to the graph, you will get an idea that what this particular line stand for what. Now this line is stand for this range. Okay, previous line is stand for x-axis. Do you understand what I'm trying to say?
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah, that's good. So you have to practice in that way. We're not going to go much deep because this code nobody can remember. Honestly saying, you have to learn, you cannot remember. And in the interview as well, they will not going to ask you much on this, but however, they will going to ask you if you want to draw the bar graph, what function you have to call? Dot bar. If you want to draw scatter plot, what function you will call? Scatter. Scatter plot means what? Dot like this. If you want to draw like a normal plot where the line should come, so which function you have to call? Plot. So this is a way of doing and learning.
So we can like every time we can copy from there, we don't have to write down by ourselves all those things or?
Copy means I'm not saying in that way. I'm just saying for practicing, you can copy. But like suppose in the industry, when you start working, they might give you a scenario. So based on that scenario, you can start explore internet, Google, how to make it. So you can make it from, like, if I give you example, you have to make a bar graph where I want the x-axis name AB, BC, and CD. And I want value to be 1, 4, and 20. So in that way, you have to make changes here and you can run it. So you will get the solution, right? So what scenario they have given to you, that your x-axis label name should be AB, BC, CD should be there, and your value range should be from 0 to 20. So how I achieve it, I make changes in these two lines and I got it. So in that way, company will going to give you scenario. You can explore the internet, how to make a bar graph in Python. So you will get several examples. From there, you can copy and you can start practice because we cannot remember this. Especially this graph, how to make a graph, we cannot remember the code, but you should remember the function. Subplot, if I say you which function we use to draw the bar graph, you should be remember dot bar function. Okay, and to dot bar function, what I'm passing? Name of my column and the value. Am I clear to you right now?
Yes.
Good. So in that way, you have to practice. So I think it's enough. Like you can go through this graph. Okay, you can practice more on this. Okay, you can just click on this. You like here. Okay, if you want to check image tutorial. Okay, how I can make an image. Okay, that also you can get it here. If you want to check this graph, that also you can do. So for that, what you supposed to use. You can get a complete explanation here, but what you are supposed to use here, you just have to see the code. Okay, as I've already explained you this kind of graph, right? Two things. So you can just explore this all graph, try to make a graph on your Google Colab and learn it. Am I clear?
Yes.
It's very simple. I'm sharing you this link. Even if you don't remember, no need to worry here. That how I will going to answer in the interview. In interview, Can everyone please mute? Please mute everyone. Yeah. So you don't have to worry. You just have to remember the function, because in the interview, they are going to ask you function of the graph. I'm talking about only how with respect to this Matplotlib module, not about the other Python program. In other, they were going to say you how you can apply if condition that I have explained yesterday. That there you have to write down the complete program. But such kind of program they never ask in the interview. They are only going to ask you which function you use to draw bar graph, which function you use to draw scatter plot. So you should be able to tell plt.bar, plt.scatter, like that. Okay, so can you just ping me your mail ID? I'm sharing the code right away to you. Send me your mail ID on the chat. I'm sharing you right away this code so you can open directly. All of you, please send your mail ID. Okay. Gmail ID you send. Please don't send Yahoo. Gmail ID send. Because this will open with Gmail only. So like I am sending to the Geeta once. Just 1 minute, okay? Yeah, I have a... Just 1 minute, okay? Just 1 minute, I think there might be some network. Yeah, Lekna, then who else? Urmila. If you join with the laptop, you can do it. Or anyone, they can share a screen. Anyone join with the laptop? Who has joined with the laptop?
You want to share the screen?
Yeah.
Okay.
Are you sharing a screen?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, please share it.
Post disable participant screen sharing.
Yeah, just 1 minute. Yeah, now you open your Gmail.
Sachin Barma?
Yeah. Open this, click on open. You can see here, it will take some time, then yeah, you scroll down, you can see, right? As it is, whatever graph I made, whatever coding I've done, I directly share to you, right? So yeah. Every day, whenever I will going to make a program, I'm going to share with you, so you can have this on your mail ID always. And you can see that the subject name as well, you will find this is the code for today's class in the mail. So you can save it. You can download as well. Click on file. Click on file. Do you see at the top file? Yeah, file. Then download. There is an option of download. Download IPYNB. IPYNB, yeah. So you can download the file as well. And when you want to upload it, you can just click file here. Again, you click file. Open notebook. upload, click on upload. Do you see last option?
No.
Click on upload, choose file, and go to the download. Hmm. In the download, you will going to give, yeah, select it. Yeah. Yes, open. So in my GitHub, I will going to upload such files. So you can open in this way as well. Okay, you can open. I will going to share your downloaded file. How you're going to open in your system? Just like this. If you stuck, then you can just watch this video. We are recording it, so you can watch the videos in the YouTube. How to upload the coded file having extension IPYNB in the Google Colab. So that will be the thing. And in the company, when you work, you will going to write a code in this Colab, not in the command prompt. You will not going to run in a command prompt. You will going to run in a Google Colab.
Amit.
Okay. Yeah.
Does this needs a request, access request? Because it's
no.
I've sent you a request.
No, I don't think. Can you share your screen and show me?
Yeah.
Let me stop it. Okay.
Yeah, because other they can access it. I think you might be log in with a different mail ID.
No, I did with Gmail.
Okay, you share your screen.
For me.
No, no, please, okay. Please, yeah, ask me the doubt, whatever you have. Yeah.
Okay, it's me or Mila, okay? I know we are learning Python and everything, okay? It's back end.
Mm-hmm.
But if